Hello viewers, in this session we will discuss about strength of aggregates. Before use of the aggregate, we have to identify the properties of the aggregates, because the aggregates and the other ingredients properties will affect to the properties of the concrete, like fresh property, you can say workability, hardened property, you can say strength of the concrete, and durability of the concrete mass, because this will affect to the durability of the structure. So we have to find out the all the ingredients properties in detail. In this session we will discuss the property of the aggregates, and particular we will find the strength of aggregate. As we know, 75% of the volume is occupied by the aggregates, like fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. So this is the most important ingredients in the concrete mass. So in this session we will find the strength of aggregate, and strength of aggregate is depend on aggregate crushing value, aggregate impact value, and aggregate abrasion value. And as we know, concrete is applied with the different types of the loading, like gradual loading, impact loading, and others. So depending on the load, strain will be developed in the aggregates, and it's directly affect to the concrete of the mass, particular the strength and the durability of the concrete mass. So we have to find out the strength of the aggregates, and the strength of the aggregate we can find with the three tests, like aggregate crushing value test, aggregate impact value test, and aggregate abrasion value test. Aggregate crushing value test, this type of the test will gives you the relative measure to resistance and the aggregate crushing under the gradually applied compressive load. And in the aggregate impact value test, this test will give you the relative measure the resistance of the aggregate to sudden shock or impact loading. And if we talk about the aggregate abrasion value, the resistance to wear, it means the surface offered to by the aggregate, is termed as aggregate abrasion value. So by this test you can easily find out the strength of the aggregates, because this is the most important ingredient in the concrete mass. Let us start with aggregate impact value test. This method covers the procedure for determining the aggregate impact value of coarse aggregates. You can refer Indian Standard 2386 Part 4 1963 and Indian Standard 383 1970. If we talk about the apparatus used for determining the aggregate impact value test, you can see on your screen, this is the aggregate impact testing machine, and we required balance and weight for weighing the aggregate sample, and we required Indian Standard sieve 12.5 mm, 10 mm, and 2.36 mm, because we will use the size of aggregate between 10 mm to 12.5 mm. And after the procedure, we required Indian Standard 2.36 mm, and we require oven dry aggregates, and we also require tamping rod which diameter is 10 mm and length is 230 mm. So you can see on your screen, this is the impact testing machine, and in this machine you can see the arrangement is the height will develop 380 plus or minus 5 mm. It means approx 38 centimeter height will be allowed to fall to the aggregates. And here you can see this is the handle, and this is the locking pin, and this is the lifting handle, and here you can see this is the release valve. When we are applying the loading, particular impact loading on the concrete, on the aggregates, we require release valve, and we will apply the loading on the aggregate and other part of the impact testing machine, we require cylindrical mold and steel cup. So this is the arrangement of the impact testing machine. Now let us understand the procedure to finding impact value of the aggregates. First of all, you have to collect the sample, and in that sample we require oven dry aggregates which is 12.5 mm passing and 10 mm retained, and then fill the cylindrical measure with diameter is 75 mm and height is 50 mm, and we have to fill the aggregates in 3 equal layer, and each layer should be tempered by the tamping rod, and the measure is filled to overfly and stuck off the level. So first of all, we have to fill cylindrical mold with the aggregates, and then we have to identify the net weight of the aggregate by this cylinder. This will be W1, and our next step is the whole assembly sample is filled into the cylindrical steel cup. Here you can see on your screen, this is the cylindrical measure and this is the steel cup. After finalizing the W1, which is our sample, and then we have to fill these aggregates in the cylindrical steel cup, and then we have to put this cylindrical cup into the impact testing machine. So here the arrangement of this machine is that the impact loading is allowed with the 14 kg by the rising of the handle and allowed to fall with its own weight. And if we talk about the number of the blows to allow on the aggregate to crush, so we have to apply 15 blows on the aggregate by this rise of 38 centimeter with this handle and allow to fall its own weight. But remember the one thing, the interval between two blows should not be more than 1 second. And after the applying the impact loading of the 15 number of the blow with the 38 centimeter falling height and with the less than 1 second interval, and we are getting the crush aggregate, and then we have to sieve this aggregate on the 2.36 mm IS sieve, and we have to find out the sample which is passed from the 2.36 mm IS sieve, which is the fraction passing the sieve, which is W2, and with the help of the W1, which is our sample, and the W2, which is the crush aggregate, and with the help of the W1 and W2, we can easily find the impact value of the aggregates. Now let us discuss the calculation of the impact value of the aggregates. W2, which is our sample, W1, W2, which is the fraction passing from the 2.36 mm ISU, and W1, which is the weight of the sample, and multiply by 100%, and we can easily find out the impact value from this equation, and result you will get with this equation. And as per the Indian standard criteria, the aggregate impact value should not be more than 45% for the aggregate used concrete and other than the varying surface, and more than 30% concrete used for the varying surface as a runway, roadway and field pavements. So this criteria should be kept in mind. Your aggregate impact value should not be more than 45% in the concrete use, and particular varying surface the aggregate should not be more than 30% if you are using the aggregate in the varying surface. So the before the using of the aggregates, you have to identify the impact value of the aggregate. This is the one of the strength of the aggregate. So impact value is one of the strength of the aggregate, which is resistance to the impact value has been applied in the concrete mass. Thank you.